welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is Aneel Waraich, the Executive Vice President of Steppe Gold. And Aneel, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm great, Steve. How are you?
I'm doing very, very well. So lots of things to talk about with the company. First off, your project is obviously in Mongolia, and there was a recent election in Mongolia, and the ruling party had a landslide victory, the People's Party. So just some thoughts on someone who obviously has a major project in Mongolia.
Sure. I mean, we're very excited to see this news. It, as expected, this is the People's Party that have been in power the last 4 years. So the way we look at it, Steppe as a company, we have another 4 years of a stable, supportive government. They've been very supportive over the last 4 years for mining companies, especially Steppe Gold as well. As you remember, early in the year, we landed an investment from the Sovereign Fund in Mongolia as well. And so they're very supportive of new gold producers like us and foreign investment. So it's a great time to be doing business in Mongolia. They truly are open for business. And now we have the same party who's going to be very supportive for the next 4 years. So that was great news that came overnight.
Okay, let's talk also about the project itself, because you know, last time you and I talked, we talked about where the company's at as far as being able to pour gold. So give me an update on the operations.
Yeah, so we're actually now in month three of startup or ramp up, so we call it. So we have been producing gold, like we mentioned in May, ever since, and selling it as well to the central bank. So we're obviously supporting the government by helping them increase their reserves. But operations are smooth and steady. We're looking forward to updating the market in the coming weeks on how our first quarter ever as a producer has panned out, and hopefully we're in a situation to announce commercial production in the coming weeks as well. And then we'll continue to scale up production over the summer and try to hit our targets for the year.
Obviously, that's fairly significant considering where we're at as far as the gold price is concerned.
Yeah, absolutely. The gold price has obviously ticked along while we've been in production. So every time we produce and sell gold, we're actually getting more cash in the till. So it's quite a favorable position to be in, and we're hoping to obviously optimize and scale up production further and take advantage of this strong pricing environment.
Let's talk about your exploration, because you still have more to explore on your project. So just update everyone about where you're at as sort of the next steps, and also about your PFS as well.
Sure. So actually, we're going to be restarting exploration on our UK project. So the UK project is a very license we have in the southwest of the country. It's an undrilled license. We've had drilling all around us, but not on the license. And so we've done all the groundwork, IP, magnetic soil sampling, and probably just in a couple of weeks, we'll actually start a trenching program first and then drilling. So that'll be in July. So we'll expect news flow, I guess, August, September, on the back of us starting in July there. And then while that's happening, we're actually working on our resource and reserve update for the ATO/Mungu project. So we're putting a maiden resource on the Mungu deposit, where we've had some exciting exploration results already released to the market. We have 11,000 meters of pending results. That'll be the last set of results as part of the 30,000 meters that we've drilled in the last 2 years to be able to update the resources and reserves on ATO-124 and Mungu.
Well, it sounds like it's going to be a super busy next couple of months for the company.
Absolutely, because I forgot to mention is we'll obviously kickstart, which we've started slowly now, but we'll expedite the feasibility study on the phase two expansion project. And I think you know, without any bottlenecks on the metallurgical side in terms of processing, we should be able to deliver that to the market by Q1 next year.
Well, congratulations on that. We look forward to sharing more news as it becomes available. Aneel, great to see you again. Stay safe and we'll talk soon.
Thanks, Steve. You too.
All right, Aneel Waraich, the Executive Vice President of Steppe Gold.